Welcome once again to the Jianyang Cultural and Sports Center Natatorium here in Chengdu. FISA World University Games, part three of today's schedule, and we've had two finals already. This is our third. And we plunge into the pool for the men's synchronized platform final. And representatives of the nations will have two divers who will be looking to try and mirror each other as they plunge off the 10-meter platform and try and woo the judges. Both studying in Berlin. Tom Waldsteiner's first participation competing in this discipline. Off a somersault in pike position. Strong dive there. And again, it's going to be around about the 50-point mark. Look at this for synchronization. Coming out, reaching. Lou's entry. Not as good as Tom's. In saying that, you saw that Tom's feet were just a little bit not as vertical as he preferred, but still, it's a good strong performance there. Good strong dive, 50.4. The panda mascot Wong Bao will be firmly behind these two. Zigan Huang, Ling Yan. It's the back half somersault.
Hey.
Well, they're just maintaining a certain level, these two divers. Zigan Huang, 24 years of age, competing in three events. Yeah, just picking up, losing a few points, I think, just for the entry. A bit more than a little rip there, 53.4. And after round two, Huang and Yang, they got a 8.4-point lead over Massenburg and Waldsteiner. Yamada and Nishida, just a few points further back. Back to the top for the German duo. Now it's starting to get interesting. An inward 3.5 somersaults. Tuck position, 407C, 3.2, the DD, with 3.5 rotations in that tuck position, but with their backs to the wall, of course, as you can see. And they'll make the adjustment there, because it's inward, of course. See, that's a great dive, and I know that that Tom was battling hard to just get himself the right point of entry, but such a good synchronized dive that really is. Just look at that, the head maybe a little bit too far back for Waldsteiner, but still going to be a very good score. Technically, that was well executed, and the judges will give them points for that. And a little splash, 81.6. And that is a fantastic effort there, 3.2 the DD. As I said, as it starts to get more complicated and more technical, it becomes a lot more interesting. Now 405B, so this is an inward 2.5 in the pike position. One less rotation. But entry will, they'll suffer with the entry. I think that there was non-vertical entry there coming in from Zhonghui Xin. Just crashing over a little bit, as you can see from the backsplash, and synchronization lacking a little bit, so they won't get the same scoreline, but they also have a one less rotation, so it's 2.8 the difficulty. 60.48, still a solid score, but obviously less points because of that entry. Japan's Yamada and Nishida. And it's a back 2.5 with 1.5 twists in the pike position. Go up, back up to 3.2. A lot of dive in this. Third after round two. Well, as far as the entry is concerned, that was impeccable. We'll take a look at the synchronization was off. We can see that. It's still going to be a high score though because of the degree of difficulty. Both executed well. Just entry suffering a little bit, especially for Nishida. 70 odd points, 72.96. Yeah, that's a solid score. And now it's Huang and Yang who go for an inward 3.5 in the tuck position, 3.2. They're looking very, very good, aren't they? It's a solid dive, that is, from the Chinese duo, Zigan Huang and Ling Yang. And they'll get it'll be 80 plus for that. Yeah, that's coming out of that final rotation was it was poetry in motion. Good entry. And 86.4 is a very good score for them. They're still ahead. What, 13.2 lead over Massenburg and Waldsteiner. Yamada and Ishida, 13.76, or 13 points back. Yeah, Massenburg and Waldsteiner. This is another complicated, very technical dive. It's a back 3.5. Tuck position. So this is their most complicated dive out of the six that they've decided to pick. So the entry was always going to be quite complicated. There's a lot of dive, remember, but they'll be a little bit frustrated with that. Nico Herzog, you go just watching on, and just look at that, just the entry slightly overcooked and lacking a bit of synchronization, especially with Tom Waldsteiner. And lose crucial points from the judges, 55.44. Republic of Korea's Kang and Shin, they go for a forward 3.5 pike. So you got the skip to the edge, and then over they go. That's nice, it's a good dive. Well executed. Lovely skip, just good communication. They go in a little bit off with the synchronization. Get it back at the end. Bit of splash, so not going to be an amazing score. You can see that they're fighting to try and come out of that final rotation. 65.7. Shuta Yamada and Ryo Nishida. 170.76. Third coming into this. got a chance to move up. It's an inward 3.5. Got a chance to move into second position. That's good. Is it good enough for them to get more than 68 points and move above Massenburg and Waldsteiner? Again, the fight to get themselves into that good out from the final rotation, and a little bit of splash at the end, of course. But 68 points is the target, 68.16. They do move ahead, and can you imagine? They move ahead by 30.38 of a point. So just edging themselves ahead into second position. Before Zigan Huang and Ling Yang, the battle for that silver is going to be fierce. There again, let's see what the Chinese pair can do. Reverse 3.5, tuck position 3.4. It's a massive dive, this. It's a lot of dive. Well, that's absolutely exquisite. Synchronization, little bit off at the end. Well, right from the start, in fact, from a liftoff, but they kind of get back into sync. But it's still going to be a high score just because of how difficult it is. And they come out of that final rotation and are reaching limited splash. It's going to be up in the 80s, 88.74. And it's a comfortable lead going into round five. So Zigan Huang, Ling Yang, 284.94. 46 points behind Yamada Nishida. Less than a point behind them, Massenburg, Waldsteiner, boys from Berlin. I like that a lot. And you know, the communication and how they work well together. It's nice to see the Aussies, Natalie Fan and Rebecca Stapper getting behind the German duo. It's going to be a good score for them. Working really well together. You see the communication up on the platform. Lou Massenburg just making the call and taking Tom into the tempo, into the rhythm. 68.4. Just put a bit of pressure on the on Shuta Yamada and Ryo Nishida. But first up, here is Min Hyuk Kang. It's an inward 3.5 tuck, so it's a 3.2 DD. Oh, that's great. That's a great dive. And that will nudge them up and give them an extra few points that they totally deserve. And it's got a big DD as well, 3.2. But just look at that. They really have mirrored each other. Entry a little bit off. But 75 plus, definitely. Yeah, 77.76. That's a very good score there. Shuta Yamada, Ryo Nishida, it's a back 2.5. There's 2.5 twists thrown into this in the pike position. This is just not a small dive, is it? It's super complicated. And you get the jackpot if you nail it. That's not bad at all. You know, that's not bad. I'm just trying to read it to see exactly where they're going to go with this, but you can see that Yujiri Haishi is happy man. Coach for this Japanese team synchronization. Yeah, that's not good, is it? A little bit off, of course, but 73.44, you can just understand. Execution was just lacking. It could have been so much bigger, but that's still a good score, 73.44. And he just moved above Massenburg and Waldsteiner by, what, 6 points, which means that they're going to be jostling for that medal with the German pair right till the very end. Zigan Huang, Ling Yang seeking a second gold medal today. This is forward 4.5 rotations, tuck position, 4.5 somersaults, 109C, 3.7 the DD. Get all of this in. Who knows where they're going to go with the judges. How good is that? And even the Chinese pair found it quite complicated to get themselves into that vertical position for entry because there's so much dive there. Little bit of splash on this side for Ling Yang, but come on, you've got to give them total credit. That's a big dive. Entry was a little bit off. But in terms of execution of dive, wow. That was impressive. 88.8 and a total tally of 373 points. 0.74. Well, dominating this men's synchronized platform final after round five. It's Huang and Yang, top of the table. Yamada and Nishida stay ahead of Lou Massenburg and Tom Waldsteiner, the German duo, with Minhyuk Kang, Zhonghui Shin of Korea Republic, just out 295. 3.2 DD for the final dive for the boys from Berlin. Now, it's an opportunity, this is. Shuta Yamada and Ryo Nishida have got a 107B, so it's a DD of 3. They've got a chance now. Get points, need points. It's a good dive. It's a good dive indeed. You don't want to say good, I just mean that it's solid. They can be happy with that. Love the synchronization. They're just growing over time. Just the entry is a little bit off, but that's still going to be a high score. Is it going to be enough for them to just get the better of the Japanese pairing of Yamada and Nishida? We'll have to wait and see. Okay. That means they need to get 70 points, the Japanese pair. Let's go back to the Republic of Korea's Minhyuk Kang, Zhonghui Shin. Seven points will get them silver medal position. It's a great dive. That is a fantastic effort. And they're going to be pushing the German pair and the Japanese pair right to the very end. 74.88 is the score that's coming through. So they will go straight into third position, of course. Depends on Shuta Yamada and Ryo Nishida, how they get on. But that's a great score. That is, might not be enough to get them a medal. Now, Shuta Yamada, Ryo Nishida. It's a forward 3.5 pike position, a DD of 3. And they need 70 points. to get themselves 70, more than 70.32 points to get the silver medal, at least. I think that could be enough. I think that it's going to be quite close, but that should be enough. Oh, well, the entry's not great, is it, on the far side? And they are. Synchronization lacking certain parts of the dive, but just look at that entry. They'll be penalized for that. They'll lose crucial points. And you can see the reaction. I don't think it's going to be enough. 68.4, they go into second position. So guaranteed silver medal for Germany's Lou Massenburg, Tom Waldsteiner, and Shuta Yamada and Ryo Nishida will take the bronze. We complete this final with Zigan Huang Ling Yang. Well, they only need more than 8.94 points to win gold, and they're going for a back 2.5. With 2.5 twists in the pike position. Uh-huh. It's only got a small DD of 3.6. Yeah. How many points are they going to get for this?
Hey.
Well, that's it's more than enough. Guaranteed. More than enough. They'll get a good score. It's not the best dive ever. And they'll know that, but it's still a very good dive, and the DD, in terms of execution, is absolutely fantastic. And the entry's not too bad, 80s, mid-80s. Solid stuff there, and it is going to be another gold medal, of course, for China, Zigan Huang. And Ling Yang completing what has been a perfect day for the People's Republic of China. The final results here for the men's synchronized platform final. Zigan Huang, Ling Yang, 461.22. Basically had a, it's as though they had an extra dive than the others. Well, dominant Zigan Huang and Ling Yang completing a fantastic and a very successful day for China as they dominate the proceedings. 7 gold medals in total. And congratulations to Lou Massenburg, Tom Waldsteiner of Germany. 2nd silver for Lou Massenburg from Berlin. And Shuta Yamada, Ryo Nishida offering Japan another medal. 2 bronze medals today.